All here to River Life Church in Dunellen, USA. We are still gluten-free. Please stand and praise with us, and don't forget, don't just sing the song. Praise the Lord! Here we go!
Can't get You're the only one who cares. You're the only one. And indeed, God is pouring out His Spirit all over this place. Revival comes when people pray. But what is happening is we are preparing our hearts to find out that God is already doing all the things that we're asking for. If you've watched the news in the last few days, you've heard terrible things. There's a storm going on in New Orleans right now, just south of New Orleans. Possibly a Cat 4, maybe even a Cat 5. There is devastation and debacle in Afghanistan. People are dying. There's pestilence here and fires there. But what you aren't hearing on the news is that in Venezuela, God is saving thousands of people at a time. In Colombia, there's revival spreading through the land. In California, God is saving bankers and drug addicts in the same altar. Right here in Florida, God is healing the sick. God is lifting up the downcast. God is meeting needs. God is overcoming all of the sicknesses we face because God is greater than whatever is the matter. Whatever is wrong, God is greater. He's at work. I'm not getting my news from CBS. I'm getting my news from missionaries in the Philippines, in Africa, in Colombia, in Venezuela. I'm hearing that the Christians in Afghanistan are saying, I don't want to go to America. We'll stay here. We'll sacrifice our lives so that people can hear the gospel of Jesus Christ. The power of God is moving. God is touching lives. Let Him touch you this morning. Reach up to Him and glorify Him as we pray. Father, we know that You're greater than the storms. We know that You're greater than the devastation. We know that You're greater than the enemy of our souls. We know that You're greater than the diseases, the pestilence, and all of the sickness that attacks us. God is greater than cancer. God is greater than diabetes. God is greater than heart trouble. God is greater than whatever comes our way. Father, we glorify You today that You're at work. You're ministering to us. You're lifting us up. And we're glorifying Your holy name for what You're doing and all of the power of the Spirit. Let us be aware of that fresh wind of revival that You're spreading across us. Anoint our speaker today, Lord, and all of our pastors across the land. Minister to our families and minister to our people today. Heal this land, Lord. Bring us again to glorify Your name and to magnify You in Jesus' holy and magnificent name. Thank You, Father.
We need a fresh wind, the fragrance of heaven. Pour Your Spirit out, Jesus. Pour Your Spirit out. Fresh wind, the fragrance of heaven.
just that right now for us. Pour your spirit out on the weak and the trembling this morning. Those of us, Lord, who don't know where to turn to next, we don't know what to say next, pour your Holy Spirit out on us, Lord Jesus. Fill us with power, wisdom, vision, strength, Lord, even beyond our years. Lord, we love you. We honor you. We need you today. Our arms, our hearts, our minds are wide open for you today, Lord Jesus. We love you. We love you, Lord Jesus. Pour your Holy Spirit out upon us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, heal people today, Lord Jesus. Lord, we stand in the gap this morning for those who need healing from COVID, healing from broken bones, healing from anything mental, spiritual, whatever the case may be. And pour your spirit out on your people. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. In the name of 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 Jesus.
That's our cry today, is let it rain. We want a fresh wind, God. We want you to pour out your spirit on us, Jesus. That's our cry. It's what we want. God, we're asking that you would hear the cry of your people. God, we're asking that you would hear the cry of your children. God, you are the only answer. Lord, you are the only answer that will fix anything that's going on in our lives, that will fix anything that's going on in our cities across the country, God. It's you, Lord. The answer's you. So we're here, God, with hearts surrendered. We're asking you, God, to do what only you can do, Jesus. Only what you can do, God. We know that you can heal the sick, God. We know you can raise the dead, Jesus. We know you can do it, God, because we've seen it before, and we believe that you will do it again. So, God, rain upon us. As we continue to go throughout this service, God, just allow us to hear what your Holy Spirit wants to say to us. Allow us to know the truth about who you are, God. Not what the world tells us, God, but what you say. God, let us understand it. Let us apply it to our lives, Jesus. Holy Spirit, let it rain. We want more, Jesus. We want more of you, God. Your word says, if your people that are called by your name will humble themselves, pray, and seek your face, God, you will hear from heaven. God, you will heal our land, Jesus. So, Lord, pour out your spirit on us. God, we thank you and we love you for everything that you are, everything that you're doing, and everything that you will continue to do. In your name we pray, amen.
Crown me with confidence, I am. from the foundation of this earth, you knew that there were going to be days when the enemy of our soul came against us. You knew that he was going to wear us out some days, that there were going to be times he numbed us down. That's why your word builds us up with the richness and the presence of confidence that we can rise up as an army and come against the deceit, the liar that keeps whispering into our ears, that we can say, not today, Satan, because my God, my Savior at the cross won the victory for me and for my family. And we can rise up strong and be courageous, even in our weakness. Your word tells us that when we are weak, you are strong. And you love us, and you are surrounding us with that love, Lord. And we can rest in that, and we can cry out to you that we want to be strong and be courageous. Be strong and be courageous, regardless of what is coming against us, Lord. You are merciful and you are true. Satan is the father of lies. So we don't have to be filled up with his deceit, but we can rise up in your glory. And we thank you, Lord. So go with us this week and help us, Holy Spirit, to remember to focus on Jesus and not to get numbed down and not to drown in Satan's lies, but to be strong in the word of God, because he is always with us. You'll never leave us nor forsake us, so we go in your peace, Lord.